potassium and plant nutrition.
This video is going to talk about potassium and plant nutrition, especially as it pertains to container production. We will have four topics to discuss: potassium uptake, its mobility in the plant once it is in the plant, deficiencies and toxicity symptoms, and how to correct these deficiencies and toxicities if they do occur. Potassium uptake is a passive process. It is a positively charged ion which can be easily taken up into the plant. Once potassium is taken up into the plant, it is mobile.
Mobility.
If potassium is not available in the root zone or there is inadequate root growth, potassium can be remobilized from the oldest leaves and relocated up into the newest growth via the phloem.
Deficiencies and toxicities.
If there are potassium deficiencies, there can be brown scorching and curling of leaf tips, as well as chlorosis or yellowing between leaf veins, symptoms that are very evident. Because potassium is important in plant water status, it mimics a lot of the symptoms associated with drought stress. So what will happen is that the oldest leaves will become yellow or speckled or necrotic, specifically on the leaf margins. Again, mimicking more of the drought stress or a salt stress. Leaf scorch can also occur, looking as if the plant leaves have been burned. There are many types of environmental and cultural conditions that can cause potassium deficiency. Things that limit root growth, such as compacted soils, sometimes will induce potassium deficiency. Sandy soils tend to be low in potassium because the soil does not readily bind potassium. Dry environments or heavily cropped soils or excessive applications of nitrogen, specifically ammonium or magnesium, can induce potassium deficiencies. Plants that tend to be susceptible to potassium deficiencies are palms, specifically Phoenix canariensis, and leafy tropical plants.
How to correct deficiencies and toxicities.
Now, how do we correct these deficiencies and toxicities if they occur? Potassium deficiencies can be corrected by just checking the fertilizer and making sure that there are adequate amounts in your plant nutrition program. For example, if you have a deficiency symptom, you could apply a potassium nitrate solution or increase the amount of potassium in the fertigation system using nitrogen sources such as potassium nitrate. Check your fertilizer injectors for proper operation and settings or fertilizer application rate to make sure they are correct. If you are working in the system where there are high sodium levels, some reclaimed waters or some well waters have high sodium. Make sure this is not the case because sodium would also compete with potassium for uptake and can cause a potassium deficiency symptom. Also, check ammonium and magnesium levels relative to your potassium levels. If there is high ammonium and/or magnesium relative to potassium, you can also induce potassium deficiencies because these two ions can't compete with potassium for uptake into the plant.
Can potassium toxicities occur? Yes. Again, check your fertilizer and injector operations and settings and make sure that high rates of potassium have not been added.
In a nutritional program, high potassium can actually induce magnesium deficiency symptoms because they compete with each other for uptake. This is what we learned in this module.